Hello and welcome to Redstabler channel. In this tutorial, we are back to Spring Boot and we are going to show you how to do OAuth2 and Facebook social login in a very simple Spring Boot application. Let's go check it out. So here is our Spring Boot project that's serving a static HTML page. I already have a button which when clicked, it will navigate to /login URL. If you look at the code, you will see that I have prepared another button and a text span which currently hidden. We'll use that later to display the username and logout button once we have authenticated with Facebook. The first step is to add two dependencies, a starter Spring security and OAuth2 to pom.xml. If you refresh the page now, you will see that our site has been secured automatically by HTTP basic login form. But since we want to use Facebook login instead, then let's move further with the next step. We will add enable OAuth2 SSO annotation to our main class. And then add application.yml to your project. And add the OAuth2 setting. This is Facebook specific setting. What you only need to provide is the client ID or app ID. And the client secret or your app secret key. Both of these can be found on Facebook developer page when you created the app. It should be noted you need to add your endpoint URL that you've used for authentication to the valid OAuth redirected URL setting on Facebook. Because the OAuth will only work for a specific address. In this case, I'm going to put localhost 8080 and localhost 8080/login. Now I'm going to restart the server and refresh the page. You'll see that once I refresh the page, it will automatically and instantly redirect it to OAuth. This because everything on your site is restricted right now for access and you must be authenticated first. This is not good because we should let the user click the login button by themselves and then redirect it to OAuth. We can fix this by adding security configuration by extending our main class with web security configurator adapter and override the configured method. Now we will allow access to root URL and /login URL. Now we also want to retrieve the username from Facebook. So let's create another endpoint at /user and return the principal object we received from the authentication. And finally on our HTML, we will execute the get Ajax to user endpoint. And we will show logout button and username and also hide the login button. Okay, that works fine. If I refresh the page again, the login button will not show anymore. You will stay logged into the site as long as you sign on to Facebook. Now the last part, the logout button. Spring Boot already provides support for logout endpoint, so all you have to do is to make the post request to it. So I'm going to add a JavaScript to make the Ajax post to logout endpoint and clear the username and show login button instead. The important note is Spring Boot has a built-in CSERV or cross-site request forgery protection which need you to provide CSERV token along with the post request to make it work. But to avoid a complication in this tutorial, We will disable this feature by call cserve.disable method in security configuration. Now let's reboot the server and try again. That worked almost perfectly, but if you notice the weird characters at the end of the URL, this was added by Facebook to protect the security session exploit. Facebook said it's not a bug, but it's the responsibility of the developer to handle this. Well, it does look ugly and confusing for the user, so I'm going to add a few JavaScript to remove this from the URL and refresh the page. So that's it. I know that's a lot for those who are new to Spring Boot security, and I hope this should give you some ideas about it. Let me know if you have any questions or feedback, and please subscribe or like if you love this video. Thanks for watching. Bye.